Chatzorim Tovim, or Erev Tov, good evening. Baruch Haba, welcome. Shalom. This is our advanced Hebrew class, and so we welcome everyone here, including our Facebook and YouTube viewers. Tonight we're going to begin what are called interrogative pronouns. Everyone say interrogative.
Interrogative.
Say it again.
Interrogative.
Say it again.
Interrogative.
And the root of interrogative, what does interrogative mean?
Question.
Question, to interrogate. So if a police officer interrogates you, what? What is they're questioning you, okay? To interrogate, this is the root right here, to interrogate. So, an interrogative asks a question. So these are pronouns over here. I need a little music for that kind of thing. These are pronouns over here that ask questions. So, do you know English? What are interrogative pronouns? What are the pronouns that ask questions?
Who, what, where, why, when, how.
Very good. Who, what, why, when, where, how, whatever. Right? When. We said when?
Yes.
Now, what we've given to you tonight are the basics, and then we'll get into next week. There are some things that are a little different. For example, there are several ways to ask where, a particle that is a prefix that will go on a word that will slightly confuse you. We'll get into all of that next week. We're going to focus on these questions. And so, who's got the first one? Pretty simple. So I'll go with Miss Charity over here.
Mine.
Close.
Me.
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 Me. Everyone say me.
Me.
Like me. Okay? Me. Say it again.
Me. Me.
Say it again.
Me.
Say it again.
Me.
So give it to me.
Men. Men. I connect it to the good.
Good. Running out of pins again. So, me. That one doesn't.
Dry as a bone.
Me. Everyone see that?
Me.
And me means who. The next one is kind of, we could say that it's kind of the root of these. Okay? The next one we could say is kind of the root of these. So, what is it?
Ma.
Ma. Everyone say ma.
Ma.
Say it again.
Ma. Ma.
Say it again.
Ma. Ma.
Give it to me.
Man.
A.
A. So like in...
Yes. Okay. However, matovu is translated.
How good or how bad.
Ma means, literally means what?
Yeah. That one needs what?
What?
Thank you.
Thank you.
There's actually another way that we say, there's another way that we say how, which we will get into next week. But Matovu Ochaleha Yaakov, how good are your tents, people of Jacob? Okay? Matovu Ochaleha Yaakov, how good are your tents, Jacob? Okay? So, in the Hebrew, literal translation would be, what good? Okay? And, well, that doesn't make good sense. What good are your tents? That doesn't sound good. Okay? So, to put it into English where it makes sense to us, then it's how. Okay? Mamato hu. How good? What good? Ochaleha, your tents. So, say it right here again. You have what?
Me.
Me. Me. Say it.
Me.
Me. Now?
Ma.
Okay, who's got the next one? Josh?
Madua.
Madua. Everyone. Madua. 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 Say it again. Madua. 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 Okay, give it to me.
Mem.
Got it.
The
Bob. Notice very carefully here. What is your sign here?
There's no vowel,
so what?
The vowel
takes the sound, takes the vowel.
So you.
Sai.
A.
So, ma, du, a. The ayin is silent. Ma, du, a. Ma, du, a. Ma, du, a. Everyone, ma, du, a. Again. Ma, du, a. Madua. And Madua asked the question, why? In a way, because you see the root. What is the root? What did I tell you? The root of these is what?
Ma.
Ma. So what do you have here?
Ma.
So we would say why. Perhaps we could say, for what purpose? What for? What cause? In English, your child will ask you, you tell your child to do something, and they will say, what?
Why?
And you respond,
because I said so.
Okay. But you respond, what's the first word? You respond how?
Because.
Because. Because. What does because mean? Literally, it means with cause. It means you have a cause. Meaning what? Meaning what? You have a purpose. In Espanol, so the niño, he said, ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué, mamá? ¿Por qué, papá? He responds, ¿cómo? ¿Por qué? You respond with the same word that the child asked. Because in Spanish, in Espanol, ¿por qué? Significa dos cosas, dice que, why, and because. Because the question, why, in this sense, literally is asking, for what cause? ¿Por qué? For what? ¿Por qué? Te digo, right? ¿Por qué? For that. Okay, so the child asks, for what? The parent responds, for that. Saying what? In English, stay with me, in English, the child is asking, what is your cause? And the parent is responding, I have a cause. Saying what? What is your purpose? This is the question, why? What is your purpose? And the parent responds, with purpose. I have purpose. I have a reason. So this is what is going on here. Why? And I'm telling you this because there's another way of saying why. Okay? Which we'll get to in just a minute. But madua, right here, notice that your root right here. So what is your purpose, in essence? What is your purpose? Ma, what? Everybody with me? Okay, so everybody say madua.
Madua.
Again, madua.
Madua.
Again, madua.
Madua.
So, first one?
Me.
Means?
Who. Ma. What.
Madua. Why.
Again.
Me. Who.
Ma. What. Madua.
Why.
Again.
Me. Who. Ma. What. Madua. Why.
Okay, who's got the next one?
Lama.
Hana. I'm sorry.
Lama.
Lama. Everyone say Lama.
Lama.
Again. Lama. Good evening. Again.
Lama.
Again.
Lama.
Again.
Lama.
Alright, so give it to me.
Amen.
So you have Lama. Everyone say Lama.
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 And Lama means why.
So another word for Lama.
That's what I said. Yes, there are two whys. So this one is more like what is the cause? Okay. When you root here, Ma, what? Notice that you also have the root here. But you have a prefix. The lamed is acting as a prefix in essence to or lamed is a prefix acting as a preposition to or for. Por qué? For what? Okay, so it's asking why, but in a slightly different syntax, okay? This one starts off with what, this one starts off with to what. Now, if you remember when Yeshua was dying, he calls out to his father. He calls out to his father. He says, Lama sabacht ani. Lama sabacht ani. Lama sabacht ani. So now you know what this is, and it's translated as what? Why have you forsaken me? Okay? So why? Now you know what ani is. First person, singular. I or me. So now you understand this. Now, caveat, this is not Hebrew. This is Aramaic. But you notice, because they're from the same family, In fact, Aramaic uses Hebrew lettering. They're from the same family, therefore, what? It's going to be similar. This is in the same vein as Castellano.
Spanish.
Oh, yeah.
And Tex-Mex.
Good example, that's true.
Okay? Castellano is what? We would say Castellano is very, yes, it's very proper Spanish. It's the king's Spanish.
The good Spanish.
Okay? Whereas what do we have here? A lot of slang and whatever thrown in. Now, I'm not saying that Hebrew is slang. Don't misunderstand. I'm just trying to show you that if... another example would be, maybe a better example would be this. Spanish, French, Latin. Okay? If you speak one of those three languages, you will have some understanding of the other two. Not a perfect understanding. Not a perfect understanding. Okay? So, French. By the way, we were using the Spanish porqué. Yeah. French is very similar.
Pourquoi?
Okay? So French, so if somebody comes up to you and says pourquoi, you understand, you would basically understand what they're saying to you. Okay? Spanish. Latin. Italian. Okay? Latin is ancient Italian. Okay? Ancient Roman language. Okay, so all of these languages are from the same family, the Mediterranean languages, they're all from the same family. So they're all similar. Another one is Portuguese.
I'm just going to ask you that.
Romanian.
What is that, Romanian? Okay, so basically what I'm saying is that if you understand these, then you're going, if you understand one of these, then you're not going to understand everything, but you'll understand some of, and you may even get the drift, the idea. Okay? The same is true with this language and this language.
I don't know, Bob.
Okay, so when I said, when you came in, when we started tonight, we said, Baruch Haba, which means?
Welcome.
Welcome. How do you say welcome in German? How do you say welcome? Willkommen. Willkommen.
Welcome?
Mm-hmm. Welcome. Willkommen. Willkommen. What do you live in?
House.
We can spend all night doing this. The reason is because these are called Teutonic languages. English is actually a form of German, which is why they're similar. Why? Because English, the word English literally is the term Angles. There was a tribe of Teutons related to the Germans. They were called the Teutons, or they were called the Angles, and they crossed over the channel and they conquered what we know today as Anglandia, which is how you call it in Germany, Anglandia. England, Anglandia, the land of the Angles. And so what did they speak? English, which is English. So these are Teutonics. So what I'm saying is that this is Aramaic. Not Hebrew, but it is related to Hebrew. This is Aramaic, is the language of Aramea. Say Aramea.
Aramea.
And where is Aramea? Excuse me?
Samaria?
No. No. Aramaic. From Aramaic, From Syria. This is Syrian. Why? Who's from Aramaic? Who's from Syria? Rivka. Rebecca. Yes, Rivka's from Syria. Rivka's from Aramaic. Remember that Abraham sends his servant to Aramaic to get a wife for Yitzhak. And he brings back Rivka. Who is Rivka? Who is Rebecca's brother? Yes, brother.
Laban.
Laban. Laban is Rebecca's and Rivka's brother. Okay, so Yitzhak and Rivka have a son whose name is
Yaakov.
They have two sons actually, twins, Esav and Yaakov. Yaakov goes to where? Aramea, to where? The family of Rivka, to the house of Laban, the brother of Rivka, and there he marries Leah and Rachel. And from there we have the 12 tribes. Okay? Remember that all of these people, that these people are, this is the family of Sarai. This is the family of Sarah, of Sarah. Remember, now watch, let's tie it all together. Who is Sarah?
Abraham's wife.
Who is Sarah?
Abraham's sister.
Literally half-sister. They have the same father, they have different mothers. So Abraham, and the reason why this, because back then there was no law. This is how progeneration took place. Because why? Everybody was related. How do you get out of this gene pool? Literally, everybody was related. It's not, if they did not have the diversity of that day like we have today. So from creation, well, who did Adam marry? Who conceived with him? Chava. Where was Chava from?
Israel.
Oh! So he conceived with himself? Literally, in Judaism, she was a part of him. God separated the two of them, took her out from him. They were one flesh. That's what the significance of one flesh is. So, who does Seth marry? His sister. Who does Cain marry? His sister. Why? That's who was available. Now, as the population grows, why? Now you have more choices. You can go outside or whatever. But guess what? It was still very tribal. Still very familial. So what? You tried to marry within the family and you tried to marry, stay within the tribe. Even all the way up through Torah, it was still very tribal and you tried to find your son a wife within the tribe. So that Judah would remain Judah. So that Benjamin would remain Benjamin. So that Dan would remain Dan.
Isn't that what the English monarchy is?
Huh? Yes. This is why in Torah, in Shemot, in Exodus, no, actually Leviticus, you are no longer permitted to marry close relatives. Because you want to keep the gene pool. You don't want, what happens, it's not that the gene pool is not pure by intermarriage, internecine marriage. Okay, brothers and sisters, what have you. It's not that it's because it makes the gene pool, actually makes it too pure. So that any genetic defects that are taking place are emphasized, become emphasized.
See, with most of us, the genetic defects are minimalized because we are impure in our genetics. We have a big mixture in our genetics. So there are chances. In other words, this is why you see that 1 in 1,000 or 1 in 100,000 or whatever come up with this genetic defect. Because your genetics, your makeup is actually picks, chooses this gene over that gene and what have you. A cystic fibrosis child, there must be the gene from the mother and the father. Okay? In a lot of these genetic defects and things like that, it's that the mother has the gene and the father has the gene. Therefore making what? The gene becomes the dominant gene rather than the recessive gene. You remember your biology? Okay, so what happens is when there's this internecine marriage, there's this inter-familial marriage taking place, all of those genes are becoming dominant. And that means that even the not good genes are also becoming dominant rather than recessive. And so that becomes the trait. Okay, so it will eventually cause bad things to happen, which is one of the reasons why God said, don't do this anymore. Go outside the family of the immediate family bounds. What are the immediate family bounds? No mother, no father, brother, sister, grandparents, aunts, uncles, and first cousins. First cousins, iffy. Okay, there was some first cousin marriage, but the immediate family, no. Okay, it was forbidden, and this is the reason why. But, so, to go back to this, Lama Sabach Tamim, to go back to this, the Aramaic, so Sarah's mother was from Aramea. It is her family, it is Sarah's mother's family who produces Rivka, Leah, and Rachel. This is why, what Sarah sends, they send to where? Aramea for Yitzhak's wife. Where? To Sarah's family. To get him a wife. And then what? Where does Yaakov run? Rivka sends him where? Back to her family. To Laban. And there he finds refuge, if you call it refuge. There he finds refuge, and there he finds not one wife, not two wives, but actually four wives. Why four? Because each wife also gave him their servant in this contest that they have. This is how Aramaic and Hebrew come together. Okay? Remember Avraham, because we understand that Hebrew is actually the original language. So we can say that the Arameans were a splinter off of the Ivrim, off of the family of Abraham. How do we know that? Because their languages are related. Just like we know what about the English and the Germans, we know what? They're related. Okay?
And yes. This is the team name, Tani.
I am not... I would imagine it's probably because I'm not up on Aramaic. I would imagine it's probably like you to me. Why forsaken you me? Something to that effect. All right. So, the next one. Who's got the next one? Josh. Joey. Let's go to Joey.
Matai.
Yes, Matai. Everyone say Matai.
Matai.
Again, Matai.
Matai.
Again, Matai.
Matai.
Again, Matai.
Matai.
Give it to me.
Mem. Hey. Tov. Hey. Connected to you.
Okay. And Matai means So everyone say, Matai.
Matai.
Matai means?
When.
All right, here we go. Ready?
Me, who, ma, what, ma, brenda, why, la, ma, why, Matai, when.
Again.
Me, who, ma, what, ma, dua, why, la, ma, why, Matai, when.
And the last one for tonight. Anybody else? Josh?
Afo? Or if, Efo?
Efo. Efo. Everyone. Efo. Again. Efo. Again. Efo. Again. Efo. Give it to me.
Aleph. One more time. Yeah.
Pay.
Oh, there's no.
Okay, this is a cholem. Everyone say cholem. Remember the cholem means what?
Oh.
What means what? A vav goes there. Okay. So this is a shortcut here. So you have the cholem off and then the
pay.
So a fo. And AFO means where? AFO. So if I ask you, do you want to go? You would say, AFO. Where? Or you could say, Lama. Okay, ready?
Me, who, ma, what? Madua, why? Lama, why?
Matai,
when?
Efo,
where?
Again, Efo.
Efo.
Again,
me, who, ma, what? Madua, why? Lama, why? Matai, when? Efo, where?
Okay, everybody got that? So I have a question written up here. It's a question. Does everybody have this? I can erase.
Just kidding.
Good, because it's too late. So as I said, this question, those of you who come Shabbat and you hear the liturgy, you should be familiar with this question. Why? Because we say it every Shabbat. So, the first one?
Me.
Me. Everyone?
Me.
Me. So I'll put it over here, and we're going this way. Me.
Kamocha.
Say it.
Kamocha.
Kamocha. Me, kamocha. Everyone? Me, kamocha. Now, this should be a little bit familiar to you because we had the root of this word last week. Okay, so this word you had this week, this word you had last week. Mi chamocha.
Chamocha.
Mi chamocha.
Last week?
Yes.
What did she say?
I believe it's.
No. No. Next one.
Ba'al.
Say it again.
Ba'al.
Ba'al. Everyone.
Ba'al.
Again.
Ba'al.
Again.
Ba'al.
Not Baal. Not Baal. Ba'al.
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 your letters and stuff on the bottom.
You must
the,
put
the
above.
Yeah. The give one in the big.
And the last one.
Gevurot.
Close to Gevurot. It's rooted in Gevurot. Gevurot. Okay, so good. So what does it say? Me means what?
Who?
Kamocha. So you have a couple of things taking place here. So we'll go with the easiest, which you should already be familiar with, and that is this right here, saying what?
Pertaining to
second person, you. So this is, I'm asking the question of you. Okay? So this suffix, cha, the cha, when you see it as a suffix, usually means pertaining to you.
Who is like?
Okay. So if you go to last week's notes, you'll notice that there was a word that said ka'asher. Ka'asher. With this at the beginning.
Like just that. Like you.
Good. So, who like you?
Baal. Master.
Good. Baal. Baal, master. Everyone say master.
Master.
Baal is not just a pagan god. There is this thing in Hebrew roots and some other, I don't know how to say it, that say, oh, this is the name of, this is a pagan god, so you can't ever use that term, you can't ever say it. No, they don't understand Hebrew. The word Baal literally means master. It's just like there are those, there's this group out there and they say, well, we can't use the word Adonai because it comes from the word Adon, which is from the Greek Adonis, which is a pagan god. This is all baloney. Okay? It's all baloney, exactly. They do not know Hebrew and they're trying to make connections where there are no connections. Okay? Adon means Lord. Baal means master. Adonai means my Lord. In Hebrew, I knock on your door, and a child comes to the door. I would say, Mi Baal.
Who's the master?
Saying what? Who is the master of the house? Baal is the term that is used for serve, in essence. So you would ask for the Baal. Baal Bayit. Baal Shel Bayit. The master of the house. Okay? Now, Baal, who is Baal in paganism? Baal is the chief god. Therefore, what? He's the master. Therefore, he's called Baal. He doesn't have a name per se. He is simply called by his title, Baal, master. Okay? We have something similar. We have something similar. right? Which, when you're addressing an envelope or something like that, but you abbreviate it to, well, guess where this comes from? Notice that you have the two same right here. So when I was little, I would get birthday cards from a lot of mom's friends and such as that, these older ladies and whatever, and they were raised very proper, and they would address the card to me as and that would be on my card. Why? This goes back to England, where a property owner was called by this term. So you have the idea, by the way, Edward means owner of property. I don't quite live up to my name, but anyway. This one either, I mean, I get it crowned. But anyway. So what am I saying? I'm saying that this was called, this was used as like the lord of the manor. Okay? That's what this is talking about. It's not just the name of a pagan deity. It is a used word in Hebrew, a word that is used to denote what? A property owner. To that effect. Someone who is older. All right, last one, Gevurot. So I told you that it is rooted in Gevurah, which means
strength.
Therefore, you have the Gevurot here, the Vav, and the...
plural.
So this makes it plural. So Gevurot means strength. So who... you have to put in the connecting verb for English. Who is like you, master? Now remember, when you have these together, you have two nouns together. What? There is no shell in ancient Hebrew, so you use the term, this is understood, master of strength, or as the bracha, the morning bracha says, the morning
master
blessing says,
of
master of mighty deeds. Who is like unto you, O master of mighty deeds? Mi kamocha ba'al gevurot. Mi kamocha is also the title of the song of Moshe at the sea. Who is like unto you, mi kamocha Adonai? Who is like unto you, O Moshe? Okay, one of the phrases, I don't remember the whole thing, I just remember those first two words. Mi kamocha Adonai, mi. And then it goes on, I don't remember the rest of the words. Okay, that's one of the songs that they sang on the Kid of Shabbat, on Shabbat evening when I went to the synagogue 30 years ago. Okay, so everybody got this? Everybody understand? So this is the way, the reason I gave you this, this is a question, mi kamocha ba'al gevurot. Who is like you, master of mighty deeds, master of strengths? Okay, so what is this? This is an interrogative. It is a question. What is the interrogative pronoun? Me. Everybody got it? So pop quiz next Thursday? How can it be a pop quiz? I'm telling you about. Okay, 5 minutes, trivia.